Being a magician meant I had to learn a whole host of different skill sets, from levitation to mind control, even amateur rocketry. And it turns out, the more I learn, the better I get. So I thought today we'd explore how we learn human style, dog style, and even robot style. And if you stick around to the end, I'm gonna show you a dog trick unlike anything you've seen before. Welcome to Impossible Science. Your mind is filled with billions of nerve cells, or neurons. It's the fundamental unit of the brain. And navigating them is kind of like, well, navigating a forest you've never been to. Get from one point to another, if there's no clear path and you blaze a trail, that's probably the hardest it's gonna be. But as you take that trail and that path becomes more and more defined, you strengthen that connection, that route from point A to point B, it becomes easier and easier. Your mind's working the same way. Neurons are constantly changing and making connections based off of experiences and how it's recalling information. And the more you do something, the easier it is for you to recall that information. Your mind is built in a way that the more you learn, the easier it is for you to learn more. See, there's two types of learning. There's rote learning, which is pure memorization, like memorizing the alphabet. You don't have to have an understanding of the alphabet to memorize the individual facts. The problem with rote learning is it's pure memorization, which is why cramming for a test is never a good idea. And meaningful learning is really about the idea of those individual facts are connected to each other in your mind, and they're firing off from different neurons to help reinforce ideas, which gives you a better understanding of a subject. So the more you learn, the more neurons are firing off when you're actually recalling information, which makes it easier for you to learn even more. Now, when it comes to Kepler, Kepler learns a little bit differently. Kepler doesn't necessarily reason like we do. He's too busy processing in the moment. When they do something good, you let them know that they're doing something good.
Speak. Good boy.
And when he does something you don't want to do, you have to let them know immediately. Otherwise, they're not really going to process what they did a few hours ago or even yesterday, and they're not really thinking about tomorrow. So when you want to train your dog, we have to build off constant reinforcement. Grab. Good boy, good boy. Every time he grabs something, I reinforce that. Here, grab. Good boy. Here, come back, thank you. You want to try something smaller? Grab. Good boy, all right, yeah. What he's really spotting is this new turtle over here. Do you want this? Okay. And then there's aibo. Aibo is an autonomous robotic companion, but he's not just your average robot. See, aibo is programmed with artificial intelligence, and he's actually learning about the world around him. That also means that there are no two aibos in the world that are exactly alike, because each one is learning from their own experiences. So what is AI? Artificial intelligence is how we talk broadly about machines that mimic human intelligence. These machines have all of our senses, maybe even more, can gather info, reason, and make decisions just like we do. Aibo uses these senses to learn. His forward-facing camera uses image recognition to recall things like my face and where he lives. His motion sensor and infrared time-of-flight sensor allows him to navigate his surroundings. He's even got a series of sensors on his head and his back, which allow him to feel when you pet him. How cool is that?
Strike a pose.
And his microphone helps him hear commands. But he also understands the difference between positive and negative feedback, just like Kepler. All right, Kepler, I want you to do your card trick, okay? Please? If you would, pull out any card you'd like, and if you would, sign your name across the face of that. I'm thumb to here, tell me when to stop. Place your card right there. Kepler, do you see the card? See it? All right, come on, bud. Come up here. Ready? Ready? Grab. Pull one card out. Wait, let me... Is that your card? Good boy! Good boy! Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this episode about learning about how we learn and how to teach an old dog new tricks. And if you enjoyed learning about my goofy experiments, well, let me know. Like the video, share the video with your friends. And until next time, stay curious. Because the right question changes everything.
Kepler, what do you think?